Hello and welcome to my creating room. I'm so excited to have you here, to be sharing this space with you, to jump into Photoshop, to talk about creating. It's my favorite thing to do in the whole world. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a self-portrait artist and I work alone a lot. So it's super nice to have you here with me in this space, in my space. This is my office, my favorite room in my house where I make everything that I make pretty much. So let's dive in, because this is a really special picture. We've got an image here where I used cardboard boxes and some construction paper to make pretty much the whole thing. So let's see how that's done. We're gonna go to the end of the layers here, to the very bottom, to look at the background. Here we have a background, just a field shot at dusk. The sun had gone down, it was almost dark outside, super, super soft light. And that's something to mention, that when I do photo shoots, I always have super soft light, always. It's really important to me for my personal aesthetic to have really, really soft, even light. And so that's why I shot it this time. Here we've got some light coming into the space to make some interest in the center. And then I decided to start blending the background so that there were no inconsistencies. We've got, there we go. That's the big one, darkening that background to create a gradient, a beautiful gradient, because I knew that eventually this would have stars in it. And I wanted to create this nighttime look, this believable nighttime look. And so that's how all of these choices were made for the background, shooting it at dusk, making sure it was nice and dark, creating that gradient where the sun was, so that right along, just right through here, we've got this area of like more pink and then some yellow and some green and some blue and creating that little rainbow effect. Here we have a star. This star was just a paper cutout of a star. I used blue construction paper, cut out a star, brought it with me, set it down in the dirt, and then was able to edit it into the field because of that. So darkening that down, creating the shadow. Now where I had it in the dirt, it was just kind of like just stuck in the dirt, like not really behind a lot of things, very clean. Here though, it's in the grass. Like we've got grass covering the front of it, so we had to put a shadow there, right? And another star with the shadow coming on the star that we just put in. So we've got a background star with a shadow. Darkening that. One more star, why not? And then some boxes. I just photographed, you can even see, I photographed these boxes just outside. So it's not perfect. That's my hand, part of my hand holding it on. It's not perfect, not cut out perfectly yet, but just photographed the boxes outside so the light would be the same in that space. Okay, and then we're going to stack some more boxes. And there I am. So in order to shoot myself for this picture, because the boxes were stacked so high up, I had to make sure that I was also high up, but I couldn't get that high up. So I photographed myself standing on a stool so that I could have this effect of really reaching and being up higher. And in order to really elevate myself, I put my camera down lower so that I was looking up at myself while I shot myself. So there we have this image of me, and I'm just going to really make it look like I'm there by making some slight adjustments on my body with the lighting. Good. Okay, and then you see this star coming in? We gotta really like make that look good. So we're gonna add this little step here, which is the boop, bursts of light. And I love doing that, just adding a little bit of interest. And that was done really quite simply. So if we zoom in, let's just do it again and see if we can get that look. So we've got this little star, and I just took the lasso tool here and just made a shape where I wanted the light to beam from, and then another shape just like that. Right click and feather, let's say, I don't know, 7 pixels. We'll see. I'm not really sure, so we'll see how that goes. And then create a curve adjustment layer, and from the shadows, see, start to pull up. And that's how I created that effect. And so there we go. Let's zoom back out, take a fresh look. Good. Darkening, creating this sort of fairy tale vignette around the outside edges. I love doing that, just creating a really, like, really harsh vignette to let people know we've got a subject to look at here. Texture always helps in my work. And finished. It was a pretty complicated edit, to be honest. I had a lot to think about in terms of the angles of how I shot everything. That was the hardest thing. So I have the stars, and I had to shoot those on the ground from all different angles, from straight on, from slightly lower, from slightly above, because with compositing, it's almost impossible to know exactly where everything is going to be placed in the frame. And even if you do know, you might be wrong. Your angle just might be off. So I shot each of these things, the boxes, the stars, myself, from many different angles, just to be sure that I could add them all in appropriately. So that was the big thing for this image. Shooting it at dusk was really helpful after the sun had gone down. Really creating that deep, dark blue look was vital to making this look like it was nighttime and the stars were out. So I hope that you enjoyed that. I hope it was helpful in some way, and I'll see you next week.